Chris Lepree here at SIONICS today with my buddy and overall happy customer service rep, Colin.
Oh, that's all I am to you? It's just a customer service rep, Chris? Hey, guys. Colin here.
So we're going to talk about these barrels today, man. First of all, it's for Glock Gen 3, Gen 4, Gen 5, 19s, and then it will also fit the Glock 45 and the 19X.
That's correct, Chris. Right on.
Mm-hmm. Awesome.
Yeah, so a majority of people out there, this barrel will be great for. I mean, we were potentially talking about coming out with a 17-sized one, but for now, we're probably just going to stick with the 19s. Okay. It just seems to be the much more popular option. That is what a majority of individuals have requested anyway.
Okay. So we have DLC coated, right? Suppressor ready.
Yep.
And let's talk. I noticed the feed ramp is a lot different than the rest of the barrel. What do we have there, Colin?
Yeah. So what's nice about these is you guys are already familiar with feed ramps on our rifle barrels. We took the same concept and applied it to these barrels. It is a hand polished feed ramp, which is going to be it's going to give you the best, you know, feeding option, right? So the same idea as with our rifle barrels. Okay. You're just going to have great reliability feeding all different kinds of projectiles, whether it be, you know, ball ammo or hollow points, stuff like that. Just a lot more reliable when you start polishing those feed ramps. And it's when you see a lot of the DLC barrels on the market, a lot of those guys don't polish feed ramps because it's, as we found, very hard to polish DLC off. It's, you know, on our standard rifle barrels, they're FOSS coated. So it's pretty easy to blast through that when you have the right abrasive to polish those feed ramps. But a lot of guys on DLC, they just won't do it because it's, I mean, the time that it takes to polish that surface is exponentially increased when you have a coating like that.
Right on. So that's a good point. Let's talk about the actual rifling cut. So we talked, what's it called? Single point?
Single process technology.
Single process technology.
Yeah, so pretty interesting, to be honest with you. I really didn't know a whole lot about it before we came out with these. But after doing a ton of research and shooting these things, I've found that it definitely nets the end user much more accuracy. So the big thing with single process technology is that it uses one cutter throughout the rifling process to cut the lands and grooves. You know, with standard button rifling, you'll have five or six cutters that take care of cutting the rifling. When you go to one cutter, you have much less deviation between the lands and grooves. So throughout the entire rifling process with the single process or single processing technology, we've actually found that there is a less than 10,000th deviation between the lands and grooves. So that's, you know, when you look at precision barrels on bolt guns, like whether it be, you know, Bartline barrels, stuff like that, they're all using the same technology. So it was pretty cool to bring that to a barrel like this. It definitely gives you that increase in accuracy over stock barrels and over, you know, other manufacturers that are using that standard rifling technology.
That's awesome. And then also this thing has some type of target crown on it, huh?
Yep. Believe yeah, so it's an 11-degree target crown. So that definitely is going to net the end user more accuracy as well. It just goes hand in hand with, you know, kind of the pedigree of this rifle or this barrel. We're definitely trying to get the most accurate barrel out there for this platform. You know, not everyone is going to be able to shoot to the level of accuracy that this barrel can provide to you.
Exactly.
But you know, as everything we've ever talked about that I've, you know, anytime I've been on this in front of a camera with you or with Josh, you know, we always talk about training, you know, it really just comes down to that. You know, we know that there's going to be guys out there who are going to ask, you know, what is your accuracy guarantee? And to be honest with you, when it comes to stuff like this, it's going to be as accurate as you can shoot it. You know, it's a pistol barrel.
It comes down to the user at that point.
Exactly. You know, exactly.
Even factory barrels in most guns, even some of your crappiest guns out there, will outshoot 90% of the population.
Yeah, 100%.
So it's absolutely based on the shooter's ability. So let's talk about, we have this O-ring on the end. So that is just for maintaining lockup of the thread protector. It's not for barrel lockup,
correct?
Like a Mark 23 or something like that.
Yeah, you've got it. So being that we are including thread protectors with all of these barrels, we thought it was necessary to also include an O-ring, because I know that every single threaded barrel for a pistol that I've bought that comes with a thread protector has not come with an O-ring. And you find out very quickly why an O-ring is needed when you're shooting unsuppressed. So we went with a high-temperature O-ring on there to retain the thread protector when you're shooting unsuppressed, which actually kind of segues us into, since we're at the end of the barrel here, or towards the muzzle end, you'll see that there are, you know, these little recess cuts on either side. And that's going to be designed with the Killer Innovations Velocity Compensator in mind. We kind of worked with them to ensure it's going to have a great lockup with that, just because we've been very impressed with that compensator. We think for the value that you're getting is very high with that compensator versus other options on the market.
So just to rehash this, if for some reason you were to lose your bushing, we were talking, you can just go to like a hardware store and buy
these. That's what I've done on a lot of my rifle. I mean, even, you know, I've had friends with bolt guns that are just the most insane bolt gun that costs more than, you know, my car.
Right.
And when they have direct thread cans on there, they're just using an O-ring to retain it on there. You know, obviously, there's a lot of different methods for doing that, but quick and dirty, I've seen it work very, very well. So, you can easily just go to, you know, Ace Hardware, or Home Depot, Lowe's, whatever's near you, and just get a pack of O-rings, and they're like $5. That's honestly what I do. Just go buy a pack of O-rings, throw them in your range bag, you know, throw them wherever, and you just have access to them if they ever go out.
And what was the name specifically you recommended on the O-ring? It was, you said it earlier.
Vitron. The only thing is, I don't know if you'd be able to find Vitron O-rings at like local hardware stores. That would be more of a niche product. It's actually the same material that they use in the mil-spec extractors. Like they'll use a Vitron O-ring, like in a four-coil extractor. You may be able to find one, but realistically, like, so to give you my personal experience, you know, on my SPO1 that, you know, I use in competition. When I first bought it, it did not come with an O-ring. And you learn very quickly, like I said, that you need it. And I ended up just going to Ace and I bought a pack and threw it in there and it ended up being fine. I did replace it and have replaced it many times, which with these, you will not have to replace them. The initial one you get, you won't have to replace it as frequently as a non-high temp O-ring, but in a pinch, you could go to Ace Hardware or whatever and buy one.
Good to know. And then these are available now, right?
Yeah, available now on the website. We did special pricing for Labor Day on these. And don't tell Josh, but I haven't taken it down yet. I forgot. We'll probably leave it up until the end of the week, though.
Right,
so
on.
Pay attention to that.
And then limited run, right?
Yeah, so these are a limited run. We will not really be doing these again. I mean, they're actually a lot more popular than I ever thought that they would be. We sold quite a few of them. To be honest, a lot more than I was expecting. Get them before they're gone, because we will not be doing these again. Definitely limited.
Are they compatible with any other? I just blanked out. Compensators.
To be honest, we haven't tested that. I'm sure with like the KKM style comps where it's a clamp on, it would be fine. So any kind of compensator that does not require a proprietary threading or proprietary cut on the barrel, just based on the inherent design of this, I don't see why it would not work.
So that brings me back, it is 5x28 for your standard
half 28.
Sorry,
yeah,
half you're by good.
28. One half by 28 is going to be the thread pitch on that. So that, I mean, the most universal for this platform. It makes a lot of sense. So that's why we chose that.
Okay. Cool.
Yeah. But no, I mean, these are available now. We are shipping them pretty fast, to be honest with you. We are trying to get to them as soon as the order comes through.
Yeah.
So we're getting through them pretty quickly.
Right on. Also, if you order one, you can order one of these fine T-shirts that we're
actually. I think it comes with it. I forgot. I probably should have mentioned that. Yeah. If you order one of these, you get a cool mug or a flask, and you get a T-shirt too.
You get a flask, huh?
Yeah. Well, you get you have to choose
the flask. Yeah. The choice.
So it's either you're a normal person who drinks coffee in the morning, or maybe you drink out of a flask in the morning, and we have that option.
Kick him back and cramp his old cough syrup.
Yeah, exactly. We'll take care of you. Yeah. Regardless of what lifestyle you choose, we will take care of you.
Oversized T-shirt, coffee drinker, or potential borderline alcoholic.
Yep. We got you. You got it.
Right on, man. Anything else you want to say before we're done?
Nope, that's it, man.
Cool. Right on. Also, don't forget Extreme Weapons Lube. Lubricant of SIONICS weapon systems.
Yeah, we love this lube. We've used it on these barrels a lot, actually, and there's a lot of lube out there, but this is what we like. We use it for literally everything. So